Hi, Carol here. Warm welcome to my craft room. Well, it's the first time tryout of my Tombo markers that I just got in the mail. I'm so excited, and I chose the Mama Elephant floral set. Now, I'm going to fussy cut all the flowers out, so I don't need these dies. That's one thing we can set aside because I want to do some masking. And then we're going to use this wonderful Fabriano paper. It is 7 by 9.5 inches, 140 pound in weight, and it's beautiful, 25% cotton. And I practice how to make textures, muscles on animals, and mainly I do animals on this because it takes a lot of layering, and that's what I like to do. And when you make muscles, like say on this elephant, you need to layer up with a lot of different tones of grays. So I did a tutorial on one facing the other way some time back if you want to look at that. And anyway, oh, here comes our little birds. I'm watching Carol. No, I'm getting closer to her. No, then we're both leaving. Okay, there's a little bit of fun for now. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to use an aqua brush and water, and I'm going to use this for my masking. It's 08165, and it's inkjet paper, but it has a beautiful peel-off mask on the back that they will stick wonderfully here. I decided to use the Mini Misty and quickly get them all set up with our Memento Tuxedo Black ink. And once we get that, we're going to put it on the inkjet paper, and that's a wonderful, really is a wonderful masking paper. It has just the right sticky on the back, and they come in full-size sheets, 8.5 by 11. And then I'm going to take out my fussy cutting scissors, and we are going to go to work. There we go. And these are my little stork scissors. I'm going to cut around, and I actually do cut in all of these little intricate flowers around the edges. I like to be precise when I do things like this, and get all, you know, the little nicks and crannies, as you can see me doing here. And then we're going to be able to put some things to the front and some things to the back and all kinds of goodness. There they are, all cut out on the right. So I take the main one, the one here that's going to be behind. I'm going to start building forward. So this one is going to be behind my design, let's say design, and then I'm going to take a clear embossing powder. Now, I would have rather done this in no line coloring than to have the clear embossing powder, because this way you have to stay inside those lines. And then I thought, no, I don't. I can color inside the embossing lines, but then I am going to sweep the color out as my background. Now we're going to set the masking in place however you want to design your flowers, how many flowers you want in the background, how many you want in the front. And I love the chrysanthemum that's in here because you could color all those little spaces with all rich tones. And there's so much you can do with this style of flower stamps. So here I'm just setting it up and thinking to myself, where do I want the placement? And and the only things I need to put on there, the leaves, I didn't have to use the masks because you can really see the lines in the leaves, so they were easy to put down. And right here, I'm just going to tell you about this tutorial in case you want to move it forward. When I was coloring, I made the mistake of keeping the camera on my right side, and guess what? I was using my right hand. And then when I realized it, I am right or left-handed, so I went over to my left hand. And when my left hand got tired, I put it over to the right hand. So the next tutorial I'm going to do on roses with the Tombo markers, I will make sure my camera is on the left so that you can see all of the coloring with my right hand. So we'll just move forward, and I did the best I could in the edit so you could get some of the coloring at least, and some of the ideas that I put forth in coloring. and I'll talk it through. How's that? Now, because this is clear embossing powder on a very white watercolor paper, it was a little challenging to color inside there to see it anyway. And because I'm more of a controlled colorist, like I like to do the controlling and I like to control the lines. And now the lines are controlling me because I have to keep them inside the lines if I want to do something that looks quite put together and not so watercolorish, if I could say that. But I do change that up, and I think you're going to like, oh yeah, where's the heat tool? You said you heat set it after every, there it is, yes. Oh yeah, there they come. What did he say? What was he talking about? What did he say? Yeah, that's what I thought of when I put that there. Anyway, here it goes. Boy, when I saw my hand jump up here during the edit, I felt terrible. I thought, what was I thinking? Putting my hand right where the camera is. I should have put the camera on the other side, but I do remedy it. It doesn't always stay like this. I'll explain what I do here. I like to do underlayers, meaning I like to take the colors and put all the light colors underneath and then put the dark colors on top so that when I work the water, if the water works its way down as I'm patting it, you can see all of this beautiful light color, especially under flowers. So every time I move my mitt away and you can see what I'm doing, you will see that there are there's orange and yellow and pink in this layer right here. Orange, yellow, and pink. And after each time, I heat set it because then it's right in the tooth. And then as I add the dark tones, because my dark tones will have the folds, I will make my own folds in the petals. And I'm also going to make some creases with my white pen. And this is the white Signal pigment pen. So I go around it so that I can see where the white embossing powder was. I'm going to go right inside that and I'm going to put the marks down where I want to put the deep, deep dark colors. I use three tones to make it look like that each petal has a little fold in it. And you'll see that later on. This is where I'm switching to my left hand. And I'm going to put all these little dots all the way around. I tried to get them as uniform as I could. And this way you could see it because I can switch either hand. I can draw and color with either hand. And if I had have looked at the camcorder, I would have realized I would have stayed with my left hand. But I didn't, and I apologize for that. But this is a nice way to center in your color. And, you know, it goes along with a little bit of the Zentangling idea, but just really pretty. And then I made the inside little buds inside there a little bigger. And see how you can see the yellow in the leaves just on the tips from going underneath? Now here's where I put all yellow on the tips. Now with the water, I am pulling that yellow out so that it has that runny watercolor look coming from each flower. So each flower, you're going to see the water. I let out a little bit of water as I touch the tips of the actual petal, and I get this beautiful look of bleeding color. I love that. I love the look of this. It just gets that flow, and then it still has that contained flower where you can design your flower, you can put your folds in your petals, you can do all kinds of things, but yet you have the same colors bleeding out that you used in the actual flower. And in the end, you will see how beautiful it looks because every flower bleeds out a different color. And I think that is really rich. I love that look. It makes it look like it's sitting up in a 3D effect. And as I was doing this, that's why I like to color. because your imagination just goes wild. You can do anything with watercolors. And these rich Tombow markers, I'm switching back to my left hand. So I'm really glad I did that. And I'm going over each one of them, and then I'll heat set this, the pigment ink, so that it stays a little brighter. But at the end, I use my Copic marker. I have the refill, and I use it on a paintbrush, and I put them vibrant white, and it looks really, really nice to me. This is the look I was going for, and I really loved it. So here's my leaves. I put a mint green in the bottom leaf. Then I put the next tone of green on the outside, and then I go in super deep with a deep green. And then I use my white liner, and I'm making all the lines go in there because I want the theme of white. I put the dots in the burgundy, pink, yellow, and orange flower there, and I want to have white lines going through all of my images, and I'll show you that. And now we're going on to the turquoise, navy blue, light blue, and purple. That's what I use in this flower. And on the tips, like I said, I put the deepest color because that's it's the navy. That's what I'm going to pull out as the bleed. It's going to bleed out of the flower and give us that beautiful, wet, watercolor look that comes out. So each flower will have its own color spreading out. And I love that look. So that's my, you can see on the tips right there, see all of the deeper, it's kind of like a sky blue, not so much a navy. And there, my watercolor, I am going to grab the tips of the two colors and I'm going to squirt out a little bit of water and let them bleed out so that I have that type of background. I think it looks like chiffon curtains blowing in the wind. That's kind of what I was thinking and the effect I was going for. And I'm really, really pleased with it here. See how it's bleeding out, but then the white from the embossing powder keeps the other color contained in. So that's kind of nice. And then you want to go in round circles so there's no lines. That one color actually goes and bleeds up into the other color. And really pleased with this. After each time I make that water come out of the flowers, I heat set it. And I did the two leaves here in the three colors. The undertone was a rich yellow. Then I came up to a soft yellow, all these colors in there. And then right after, I'm hiding my hand here. After all of the colors, I decided to go in with the white, and then I'm going to come over top of the white with some deep green and yellow. And you'll see that later on as I keep looking at it and try and figure out what I need to do as far as colors. And keep in mind, every flower had to have white in it, even the leaves. So that was my theme right at the start. Each, different textures is what I'm trying to say there. And as you can see in the purple flower, you can see all the little folds that I put in. And then as they fold, the orange shows through. So I really like that effect. And now I'm going to go in the salmons, the oranges, the deep orange, the soft pink on this chrysanthemum. And it dark and light, dark and light, dark and light in all four colors, to get this wonderful gradation coming up each petal. So I know my hand is in the way, and you know, it was very hard for me to edit this because for most of it, I'm sorry to say, my hand was in the way. But here you can see that I did not put enough. I'll explain what you need to do when you are stamping, is you have to really put down a lot of pressure when you're heat setting into something with a really large tooth, and I didn't do it on here. So what I decided to do was blow that chrysanthemum dry. See how the top part, you can't see the individual petals, the little petals all throughout it. So then I decided to put Versamark on it and then put white embossing powder right over it. And then I took the stamp and I put it down just like you were going to do a ghosting effect. and turned it just a little bit. And wait till you see how beautiful that looks. See, I set it on right. Then I turn it a little bit and push it down so that I get some more colors to bleed out on the bottom. Because each of these petals, each of these flowers, they're going to have that bleed of their own individual color, and they're going to mingle together on the card. And then when we do the sentiment on the 40-pound vellum, I'm going to do the exact same thing. You're going to love it. It'll match perfectly. So now I'm giving it the heat, and look at it come alive. So if it doesn't come for you the first time, don't panic. Go over it with white embossing powder. If you used clear and it just seemed to run into each other, just blow it dry, then go back onto it and use white embossing powder. Tip it a little bit and pull it down, and it will be beautiful. Trust me on that. Here you're going to see me take all six different colors, and then the darkest color of the orange with the pink mixed together, I am going to take the water brush, pinch out some water, and let it bleed down into the cardstock as my background. That way you have that soft look of sheer curtain. That's what I think of. And you get that, it's just a remarkable technique, I think, when you think of sheer curtains blowing in the wind. And that's how light you want to get these colors in the background, yet you want them to flow easily into each other so they don't have lines of bleeding. And you can get that look. Just work the water, let it bleed down. Don't bleed it out in almost like a planet, you know, where you get that ray in the background. Go for that look and leave some spaces very light, and then push it over into your next color, which will be these beautiful mint greens. I use turquoise, I use teal, and I use green and yellow in there. So you can see that I'm working the bottom ones dark because that's where I'm going to pull my color out to bleed out and go into the next color. And this way it does give you that background. It's not naked white cardstock, and it has a soft, just beautiful effect. That's all I can say. I thought of that as I was doing it. How am I going to do the background? Because there's so many background techniques for your flowers that you can do. You don't have to just paint them one color, you know, all blue or all gray or whatever. You can mingle the colors together and work off the flowers and push them out and push them into each other and get this wonderful, I don't know, it's not abstract, but it's pretty. That's what I call it. It's right here where you see my Copic white bottle, the Tombo Copic white, and I have it down there in the right hand lower corner. I use my paintbrush, and that's where you can see all the vivid whites in every flower. I brought certain portions out in white, and now I put all of the colors over there on that plastic the slip cover for your stamp sets, and I'm working off of that. And that's going to create, if I couldn't get enough a color, I would push, because we're going to need, let me just stop here. We're going to need all kinds of color going down on the bottom, because that's where our vellum is going to go. And I decided to color the back of the vellum where we put our sentiment, which is feeling better, I think it is. I'm not quite sure. And here I'm just showing you. My background is going to be, I put Versamark all the way down so I could get the exact gold trim behind my card as the gold in my sentiment. And this got stuck right there, so I had to, in the edit. So I thought I'll just explain it. This is going to be the background because this is the gold that I used on the sentiment. So I didn't have any gold cardstock to match, so I just made my own by pressing down the Versamark on four lines and heat setting it, and like I'm doing way over there that you can hardly see it, And then you have a cardstock. You don't waste gold cardstock. And I'm going to have to buy some of that when I go to Sharon's, because it's good to have gold cardstock on hand. But you know what? You can make your own. If you have Versamark, just do this. Slide it down twice. Grab your gold embossing powder that you use, well, either in your sentiment or if you just want gold in the background. Then heat set it just this quickly. And then you have that beautiful gold border for behind your card. Easy peasy, isn't it? And here is the beautiful set that I stamped out in gold. And I do all the colors going across. So we have the orangey peachy color, and then I'm going to follow it through with the deep yellow marigold. Then I'm going to come in with the blue hue behind there. And I know it looks dark, but when you squirt it with water and let it run down, what a beautiful effect you're going to get, because all of the colors of those flowers are going to run down perfectly into your vellum sentiment. You can't get any sweeter than that, can you? And it just, the whole card seems to, the flowers explode down right into the background of your sentiment doing it this way. And you have to make them vibrant at first, because once the water hits the vellum, it's going to dilute it at least by 60%. So here, watch how I do that. First of all, yeah, you just can take it across the top and squirt it out, or you can use a mister. I forgot that's the way I did it. Then I put my cleaning cloth right across it to pick up those lines. And it was exactly the way I wanted it. Clean up your mess. See that cloth right there? I love this cloth. So that's what I use. I just set it right on top. It picks it up and picks up the color that's on the this side right there. And that's all you have to do. And wait till you see how it looks. And then if there's places that you can see lines, add some more colors and use your mister. Hey, mister. I'm missing my mister, as a matter of fact. This is one of them I had on hand, but it's not the one I'm missing. The Tim Holtz one that's larger than this. So anywho, I put it down. We already put the color on the bottom of the cardstock. Now we're going to tape this. I take my bone folder, make a beautiful, beautiful flat crease, and fold it over, put some Scotch tape on the back. And wait till you see how all of that color runs straight down and right through the vellum and makes a real big impact. And with the gold sentiment and your gold background, really pretty. And don't get discouraged if things aren't going well when you're using watercolors. They're very forgiving. It's like when I took piano lessons. I always think of this. It's work, and I took piano later in life too, and it's work, and it's theory books. It's not just playing piano, it's theory and then playing, and lots of theory. So keep up at it and you will love it, absolutely love it. And there you go. You can see I'm putting more lines with the white pen. I'm putting more squiggly lines into that bottom flower. It just didn't have enough when I didn't press hard enough. So if you have a white gel pen or a white, this is pigment pen, you can make the lines easy peasy. And look, it looks identical to what that flower was like at the beginning. So here we are, way too big, still too big. I have to take some of it out and put it back. I don't want to cover that leaf. And if you knew what, let me just tell you what happened today. First, my camcorder right about here gives way. I forgot to charge the battery. So I'd only had a little bit of battery life, and I had to grab my camera. And you know my camera doesn't focus well for some reason. So you will see the switch, I am sure. So here, I took the gold beautiful script washi tape. I do this behind my double-sided tape so that you don't see just the tape. I wanted to see gold. So I put half of it on one side and the other half on the other, and I stuck that to my shirt. And then it looks really nice from the sides. It gives it a gold look instead of looking at tape runner. And then I have the tulip glue adhesive that I put underneath and just push down so that it doesn't raise up and I don't have to think about it coming unglued. And now I'm taking some more of the color from over on that plastic piece of folder that I used to put my stamps in. And I had a lot of colors on there, so I was just grabbing them and softly molding them up into the other colors. And that's where my sentiment is going to go with the vellum. And it will look really nice. So yeah, it was quite the day trying to get that. And then when I sat down, when I finally had it done, we are going to make a matching envelope, by the way. That's why the video is so long. I apologize for my long videos. And there you have the card. I have folded over. I kept the colors true to the colors that were in the flowers. Isn't that pretty? I put the gold behind the white. And on the purple there, I do add some irresistible. It's like glossy accents, but very, very thin. So I put it in the center of the teal colored flower, and I put it over the burgundy flower. Because once I did that, I didn't do it there. I did it after I got finished here, just to let you know. Otherwise, it would have been a mess. But it really brought up the folds that I made in each petal with the four different colors. So here I'm just getting out my stamp press. This is nice, easy peasy too. Set your stamps the way you like them. This is the inside of the card. You know all those little pieces, parts you get in stamp sets with the big flowers? I want to use all of those. I want to get as much use out of each stamp set. And I'm now back to using everything in my room. I'm not shopping for anything. I am using my stamps that I already have. And I don't think I used this on anything yet, so this was really nice to get out. And now that I fussy cut everything, I have them to keep and use it again. So here I go. I thought this was the gold that I used on the front, but it wasn't. It was kind of like this aluminum type color. It was absolutely, I'm looking at it going, yeeks, that doesn't look like the gold. What happened here? So I just keep going. I'm taking out, sometimes that bit of embossing powder gets in the circle, so I like to make my circles perfect on that. I want them to look like the circles they actually should have been. That's what I'm trying to say. So then I heat set it, and as I'm heat setting, it kind of looks like this gunmetal. It's beautiful, but it's not the gold that I use in the front, and I'm so glad because I like the different flower. I like that flower that we're growing right there as we're talking too. Just beautiful. Flowers are beautiful. So here you go. I'm going to show you how it isn't the difference between the golds. There's the gold. Well, I should have slowed that down. This is the difference there. One is gunmetal gold, extra fine detail, and this one is a pure gold. But I really did like the contrast when you opened up the card, so it was fine with me. I left it that way, and I left those stamps on just like that to do the envelope, and I'll show you what I do. So here I'm pressing it down, making sure I filled the center up with double-sided scotch runner all the way through. Like, I didn't leave a space because I didn't want it to warp. I put them right together, flattened them out on that gold sheet that we made. I chomped the corners. I wanted to have the round corners all chomped at the top, and here's where I put the irresistible Pico embellisher on there. And I love the way that the leaves have the white. Here's the, let me get it for you. Turn it around, Carol. Yeah, irresistible Pico embellisher in the clear. And there you have it. We put that on. See, this is my camera, and it really finds it hard really close up to zoom in. But when I have it back like this, it's not too bad. So I heat set the Pico embellisher right away so that I knew it wasn't going to get on anything. And then I take my black I have to wait, enamel accents, and I do black little dots in between the white ones on my deep purple center flower there, because the folds are almost a black color, and I thought the white and the black dots, they're super teensy. You can hardly see them. I'll hold them up to the camera, but they look so delicate. Yeah, I had fun with this card. It was the enamel accents in black. Yes. And I had fun with this card. I had fun experimenting for, I haven't, you know, used Tombo markers before. So I bought them for brush lettering, but I am going to use them. And here I had to run it through because it was just a little bit off on the one side. So I use my super duper cutter here, my Fiskars cutter that you never have to sharpen. It sharpens on its own. I just kept it in the half mode there. I keep it right beside me. And I'm taking off little slivers until it looks exactly like the other side. And then I'm just going to round the corners with my scissors. Easy peasy. Looks like you took your chomper and chomped it with the We Are Memory Keepers corner chomper. And yeah, I was going to put this on black cardstock and changed my mind. Believe it or not, I went to white. So here I have, this pack is just for envelopes. All my 12 by 12 packs. And as soon as I hit that beautiful peach color right there, I knew that's it. It's kind of like, there's a word for that color and I can't think of it. It's not peach, but it went with that. It's kind of like an apricot. So pretty. I just loved it. So I had to cut it down to 9 3/4 by 9 3/4 because it's 5.5 by 6.5 inch card. And then I score it at 4 7/8. And that makes the envelope. So I got out my envelope maker. I generally, my cards are very seldom A2 size if you watch them. So here I'm just looking to make sure. You always want to check that twice. I'm telling you, check it twice. So many times I've had it off. See how I go back and get it just to be sure? I don't want to waste this much paper just because, you know, I second guessed. We're going to take it and we're going to chomp and we're going to score. Turn it around. We're going to chomp, score, chomp, but I don't. Watch, I score. Get back there, Carol. Yes, chomp that. Mm-hmm. And then you're going to chomp, score. Mm-hmm. There we go. And then you have your envelope almost. You have to do the corners, right? And then I took the design that I had on the Fiskars stamp press and I put it on the inside of the flap in gold, in the deep gold, so that when you opened it up, you saw this. And then I turned it around and I did it on the outside. I'm going to do a little tutorial on brush lettering when I address it for you, so I'll do that in another tutorial. And there you have it. And then when you flip it, see how that's going to be like that. And then when you open it up, you see that beautiful gold. And I'm also going to put one on the flap that the post person will see. I think that'll be very pretty. So here we have it. I'm going to put some double-sided tape. Make sure you don't go all the way down because that little edge, and I always make them flush on the edges so it looks nice. I don't know why, because you don't see it, but I end up doing that for some reason. And then take off the tape and put it down. And I love this color envelope. And I am so used to making my own envelopes now because my cards are never A2 size. They're always slightly bigger. This is 5.5 by 6.5. And there, isn't that pretty? So you open it up and you see that gold flowers, and then I have to clean this Kent Oliver mat. Boy, oh boy, if anything is contacted with that, especially embossing powder, oh yes, it's going to stick to the mat. I take my mat right into the washroom and I clean it in the sink because it has this stickiness that everything seems to stick to, but I do like it. And here's the outside. You have to make sure that your flower is going straight up because when you close that, when they look at it, That flower has to face that way and the other one the other way. And now I'm going to put a chrysanthemum in the right hand portion of the envelope and still leave room for me to do brush lettering for the recipient when I mail it. I'll try and get that in for you tomorrow. And here I'm just wiping all the stamps and putting them back in their proper places right away so I don't have to lose anything. It's all right there. And I'm going to grab the chrysanthemum and put it chrysanthemum. What a word that was. I don't know who thought that up. And then I'm going to put some VersaMark down in the corner. I love to add things to the inside of the cards and to the envelopes. It just is a little something something that makes it look very pretty, and it makes the person think you went the extra mile for them. Because we do, right? That's what we do. We're card makers and envelope makers. So that's nice. Even if you buy your envelopes, it's nice to put a little something on there, and then you just quickly heat set it. And quickly, Carol, come on. I was letting it heat set so it heated up right away. There you go. And then I put one leaf. I just set it down there and had it coming out the left side. So easy peasy. And that takes care of the envelope. And I'm so thankful you joined me. I want you to have a blessed week. I want to thank you that you're so... You're just so nice with your comments, and you're so faithful in watching my videos. I appreciate that. And for thumbs upping, that really helps the placement for me on YouTube, that I get higher up to be seen, the more thumbs up I get. So I would appreciate that. And I look forward to your comments to see if you liked it. The next time I do my next tutorial with the Tombo, I will be on the left side so you can see my coloring. I hope you love these techniques as much as I love doing them. Have a blessed week, my friends. Enjoy the cards.